oscillators, you have four oscillator types, or four oscillators. Each of these oscillators can be of different types. So let me go through what these are for you. This is the original tone generator, which is, stands for the mini mode VCOs. When you select the mini mode VCO, you can then select what type of wave you want. So this can be a triangle wave, a combination of a saw and triangle, a saw, or just a pulse wave that you can select. And then of course you have your additional controls. This is just for the mini mode VCOs. You also have a Prophet BS type, which allows you to go through the various wave shapes within the Prophet BS. This allows you to use a wave file or an Akai sample as a wave, as one of your sound sources. The CEM is the Curtis Electro Music chips that were used in the Prophet 5 versions 3.2 and 3.3. And once again, when you choose the type of VCO, you also have a number of wave shapes within those as well. If you happen to be into the PPG wave tables, you can select the wave table type, and then you can sweep through the various wave shapes within the wave table. And if you happen to be a fan of the SSM chips, which were used in the older Prophet 5s, you know, like the 3.1s, then this would allow you to choose the wave shapes available within it. And there's also some additional wave shapes here, a sample and hold, a morphable saw, a morphable square, and a double saw wave. Now, as I said, there's four oscillators, and these can be set to any of those types that we just talked about. You also have rotors. The rotors allow you to be able to choose four sources, and what a rotor does is it plays one of these one after another in a cycle. So if you choose different oscillator waveforms in this, you can think of these rotors as super oscillators. And the shape of the super oscillator is that it will take from each of these sources, played one after the other, and then just cycle through those. You can cycle through them at low frequencies that you are very low, so that you can hear the tone changing, or you can jack it all the way up to very high frequencies, and then it'll just sound like a noise that's changing. It's very powerful, very unique feature that's capable, and you have two of these rotors. Now these are just the basic sound sources along with the analog inputs, so you can always take another keyboard or radio broadcast and put that in as an input. There are four mixers, and the mixers allow you to choose what the inputs are going to be that will be feeding the filters. And you have four filters that are available again. The filters can be of different types. So, as an example, what you have here initially are the ones that are modeled on the Curtis Electro Music, the CEM chips, which were on the later Prophet 5s. And then you can see here, once I've made that selection of type, I can choose among the different modes. So this is a four-pole low pass, a three-pole, a two-pole, one-pole low pass, four-pole high pass, the different bandpass filters, combinations of bandpass and low pass, bandpass and high pass, band reject filters, these are all available for you to select among. And again, this is only one type of filter. You can also have filters modeled from the SSM chips, which were the older Prophet 5 styles. You also have the capability of selecting a mini mode filter, a ladder filter, or an Oberheim state variable filter, or a comb filter as well. And as I mentioned, you have all of those types available across all four filters. Now what's interesting is that if you think of it this way, you really have a semi-modular synthesizer here, because you can pick which modules that you want as your oscillators or sound sources, and filter and switch over to Mixer 2, and then you can select as one of the inputs coming into Mixer 2 to actually be the Filter 1 mix. So this way you can have Filter 1 being one of the inputs that comes into the second mixer feeding Filter 2. So you can actually have series routing of Filter 1 going into Filter 2, going into Filter 3, going into Filter 4. So this gives you different ways of routing in series or in parallel among the different modules. This is way, there are more options on this than anything else that exists. Unless you want to build like a room full of modulars and hook them up with cables. There are 6 envelope generators that are delay, attack, decay, sustain, and release. So you have 6 of those. You also have 2 loop-in generators so that you can define loops individually inside the envelopes. You have an arpeggiator with multiple patterns available. You have a step sequencer so that you can have a 4-row by 16 position step sequencer to automatically generate melodies or for modulating any of those parameters for the filters or the envelopes themselves. Besides that, you also have 2 vector mixers as well. So you can select the inputs going into the vector mixers so that they would be different sound sources, and then you can do your own mix as a vector among those, and you have 2 vector mixers. Another section that's available is to do amplitude modulation. So you can have a carrier and a modulator source, and then modulate the 2 of them in terms of their amplitude as well to give you a sort of ring modulation effect. In terms of LFOs, low frequency oscillators, you have 4 low frequency oscillators plus a dedicated one for vibrato so that you can have an overall varying of that you can use for the oscillators as an example, so that it's like a string vibrating that you can make available. And there's a ribbon controller. This isn't wired up right now, but it will be a 2 position one, so you can hold one note and then you can glide as well with the second part. All of this is driven by software. This is what we use for the models. And inside are 6 of the Analog Devices Tiger Shark processors. And this is what gives it the pure processing power to be able to have all these different components all feeding one to the other and also doing all the modulations.